My name is David Siddons and I'm president of the David Siddons Group, and I'm really pleased to sit here today with Chris Levitt and Ashley McIntosh, who are the experts of Palm Beach. Chris, Ashley, thank you for doing this video. I know you guys are really crazy busy driving up here. It's pretty much nonstop. We're doing this video because the Palm Beach market is a big numbers market, and I want to share with the audience what's going on in Palm Beach, and especially what's been going on in the last 6 months during this COVID period. I'm going to start off, Chris. First question for you. As we come through into Palm Beach, you have some magnificent oceanfront real estate.
We do.
And it is spectacular. It's incredibly grand. It's got presence. And the price tickets that you have on these houses blows everybody else out the water. Tell us about oceanfront living up here, because I think this is really key.
Well, like you said, we have some of the finest oceanfront parcels that really exist in the entire world. We are also catering to the wealthiest individuals coming down from the Northeast, where this is actually not expensive real estate for them. You know, coming from $4,000, $5,000 a square foot in New York City to buy an oceanfront parcel in a brand new house that's $3,000 a square foot and getting everything you want, it's really a bargain, still.
So your prices, they're ranging, and we were talking off camera before this started rolling, and you were telling me, you know, $30 million for a parcel of land, which then the guy was offered $50 million almost within, to tear it down and build something new, and then there's been a trade of $100. What, the properties that we're seeing on the water, These are new properties, these are renovated properties. Kind of give us some of the flavors or give us some of the addresses of the properties that you're dealing with that we can share with the audience.
Sure, so we basically have a limited supply of these incredible properties that we're talking about. The inventory is very, very little right now, if anything. So what we're doing right now, most of the great things have traded. You know, you just sold that huge 980
property.
North Ocean, we've done a couple off markets that we can't talk about the addresses. It's a lot of NDAs here on Palm Beach.
Yeah.
There are a lot of off market deals that we can't even talk about, that you don't know about, that the person down the street does not know about. They're off the record, they're Delaware trust companies. No one knows that they've traded. This is something very unique about Palm Beach that you don't see in a lot of markets.
That's a really good comment, because the one thing that we always talk about is how we add value to our clients and what it is that separates us from the rest of the field. And you guys are right at the top of the food chain here. And there's a reason you're here. And the reason that this real estate is trading through you guys is because you access product that not everyone has access to.
Very
correct.
You know, it's about relationships, definitely. And we have the relationships to call on the owners where other agents don't.
Exactly. So for instance, right now we have a major supply issue, right? There's nothing good available.
Yeah.
But yet we have maybe 20 buyers, 20 major Forbes list billionaires that want property here in Palm Beach right now for the season. That's what they want. And they want
tough.
It and they're aggressive and they want us to go get it. So what do we have to do? We can't just go on MLS and look and see, oh, what's available? Let me send you a list of available properties. You take a look and let me know what you want to see. No, our job is
to leverage
our relationships, knock on doors, make the phone calls, call the attorney that knows the this, the that. It's a chess game. And fortunately, Ashley's pedigree in Palm Beach since, you know, born here.
1800s.
Okay, yeah, back to the 1800s.
Makes it feel really old.
You know, my connection to New York City, my knowledge of, you know, these buyers that are coming down here and how they operate and what they want and how to really service them properly. It's a great combination that we have, and we leverage these assets to get them what they want. And it's sometimes a needle in a haystack, but we've been very successful, fortunately, this season, you know, getting people what they want. And everybody has a number, right? It may not be for sale, but everything's for sale.
Yeah, I say that all the time myself. Everyone has a number. Everything's for sale apart from my wife and kids.
Yes, exactly. When you want something, you know, you're willing to pay whatever it takes to get it. So the valuations here, it's not a price per square foot. It's not a price per square foot for land. Of course, that plays into it a little bit, but it's about, I want that choice piece of property. And I want it to be better than, you know, whose piece of property.
And I don't want anyone to know I'm looking. That's one of the biggest things.
So it's less about, you know, if you're going to come up to Palm Beach and you're looking for a home, it's not just going to be about the numbers. In fact, it's going to be less about the numbers and more about who can get you the product that you need with such a small amount of supply.
And keep it private. That's huge.
Yes, exactly.
Let's move into the condo market, which traditionally in Miami has actually suffered a lot. The Miami condo market has seen big reductions in the areas. Numbers have come down, definitely deals to be had. Once you move into Broward, you get a smaller group set. You have Paramount and the Auberge, and you have the Four Seasons. And then once you come up into Palm Beach and Palm Beach Island, and this is really what we're talking about here. We're talking about Palm Beach Island.
Where you can only build, if you can find the land to do so, 8 stories high, right? So there is no room ever for a large, high 25-story luxury condominium. It just would never happen.
You'll never see anything that looks like a Miami building.
Never. No, never. So where do you have to go to get that? Well, you have to cross over the bridge to West Palm Beach. And that's where we, when I sold the Bristol Palm Beach, which is a 69 unit, 25 story, ultra uber luxury tower that sold out in a year because it was delivering on a silver platter what people wanted. You know, while we have beautiful condominium living here in Palm Beach, it's really from the 70s and the 80s and maybe like the mid 2000s, dated, low ceilings, not very compelling. The location's amazing, but we don't have those services and amenities that the Bristol offers. So that's why that building sold out so quickly.
Yeah, I noticed with Bristol, it literally every week, it was like bang, 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 bang. It felt like every day there was a transaction closing in that project. And now obviously we're dealing with resales. And I think we can recognize that not everybody is going to want a house. Not everybody is going to look for a single family because they may travel a lot and they need that lock up and leave. So, you know, if you're looking for condo living up in Palm Beach, look, Chris is the guy. He obviously has
sold this.
And Ashley, you live this every single day. You eat, breathe, and sleep.
I think
it's pretty clear that the passion comes across for what you do for your business.
Thank you. And vice versa to you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
David's the best, everyone. I mean, we know that.
Well, that's why we're here, because it's all about business. Business is about collaboration.
Yes.
And I think that, especially right now with everyone coming down to South Florida, people are trying to understand where they should stick their flag in the sand, where they should live, where they can call home, where they're going to feel comfortable. And as you said, there's a lot more to it than just finding the property. Mm-hmm. There's an entire ecosystem, a lifestyle to living in Palm Beach, to living in Broward, to living in Miami. Mm-hmm. And I think there are stereotypes that we all have. And especially if you're coming from the Northeast and you've decided, you know, I cannot tolerate another winter. I cannot tolerate social tensions. I cannot tolerate high taxes. You're going to look to South Florida, but we're getting calls from people who haven't even been down here before.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And you guys, obviously, you've had that as well.
Yes.
So that's
interesting. Trying to understand. And to your point earlier, it really is about telling the story. Mm-hmm. And we often put people in our cars and we start at one end of the island and we drive and we talk. And really just kind of, because the island is broken up into different areas. So the north end where we are now, it's a different lifestyle completely compared to the mid section of town, compared to the estate section and the billionaire's row. So it really is a story and a lifestyle that you have to explain to each of these people.
Yeah.
So much so.
Exactly. I mean, Palm Beach has a connotation of being very fancy, very kind of elitist and swinging a little bit older. That is really not true. You know, we're in the north end, the section of town where you have, I mean, listen, let's not fool ourselves. Starter homes are $3.5 million, right?
Yeah.
Anywhere in Palm Beach.
Yeah.
But where we are in the north end, you know, you can live casually. You can have a surfboard. You can have a golf cart take you to the beach. You know, you can live like you're living in an island, which is what we are on. Or you can live in the estate section in a very formal house, have charity fundraisers in your ballroom, Yeah. You know, you can do that, or you can live in a condominium and sort of, you know, pop into town when you want to. There are a lot of different options. It doesn't really, you know, there isn't one sort of stigma here anymore. And then if you look at the people moving here, you know, it's obviously the people shifting from big houses to smaller houses, or from a house to a condo, or from a small house to a big house. But you have so many new families coming into Palm Beach, hedge funders, you know, moving their hedge funds here. You know, that's another big piece of Palm Beach that people don't realize is the business shift from New York, you know, Park Avenue to Wall Street.
And you're a New York agent originally, Chris. You were selling New York for 15 years.
Yes.
As everyone knows, you know, if you might recognize Chris's face, you've probably seen him on TV a few times before. But this transition that we're having out of Manhattan, out of big urban cores, especially guys of great wealth who are being heavily, heavily taxed, and they've looked up, and we found after this COVID hit, people are sticking their head above the pulpit and saying, you know what, no more. Yeah. We've got time that I don't have to tolerate this, because now I'm not being shackled by my office on Fifth. Mm-hmm. I'm not being held back by the school with my kids that they go to every week, and now I have to take them on a Monday. Yeah. Now, obviously, it's opened up the world a lot more, opened up their eyes a lot more, allow them to come down and obviously travel, and that's why our markets have just exploded this year.
Yes. So you're seeing the hedge fund billionaire buy the $200 million mansion, right?
Yeah.
Then you're seeing his top CEO buy the $10 million mansion, $20 million mansion. Then you're seeing a hedge fund guy in his 30s buying a $5 million house. Then you're seeing his family buy a house. Then you're saying, oh, the brother's gonna move here. It's like a mass exodus down here that is trickling down from the top. So that's very interesting to see. All the office space here is locked up, rented out, you know.
Which is amazing, because you can't give it away in other cities.
Exactly. So while, of course, COVID is preventing that a little bit, but you know, it is much more spread out and larger. But you know, people are literally making the move down here. It's not seasonal, it's annual. They're living here, they're putting their children in school. Palm Beach Day, which is a school just right over the bridge, has 75 new applicants just in New York City.
Well, they split the school, actually. There's half of it on the other, but you're right, 80 new applicants. They
so
can't find placement.
That's huge.
So that segues into almost the final question, which is inventory. With such little inventory, with such demand, with lack of spaces in schools, and obviously not enough product out there, it means that you guys have to get even, and I do too actually for Miami, we have to get more creative. Three deals I did last week, they were all off market. None of them were listed, none of them were on the market, and it took me a lot of, you know, good old fashioned picking up the phone, grafting, knocking on doors, calling, and trying to kind of put the pieces together to actually do these deals.
It's a chess game.
Yeah.
It really is. It's a chess game of relationships and putting people together. That's what we do.
So final question, and this is the last one of the day. Where are we going next 6 months as we move into 2021? As obviously we don't see COVID just disappearing. It's part of this life that we're in. We don't know when it's going to end. We're not, you know, not a doctor.
No, we don't.
No one has the ultimate answer. Where do you see the market for Palm Beach going through 2021?
So our prediction for this coming season, which is going to start probably in about a month, right? In November, we are going into a inventory crisis, literally an inventory crisis. We don't have anything to show people. This is when, you know, people like us are going to excel because of our relationships. There's no other way to make this happen. I mean, there's nothing to sell. There's nothing available on the market that,
or rent for that.
And that's true. That's true of Palm Beach. That's true of Miami. That's true of Broward. I mean, obviously most people know I sell a lot of stuff down in the single family markets of Miami. I do a lot of stuff in Coral Gables and I do in the gated communities. And we've had trades that I've literally been on and off the market, or they've never been in the market. And it is getting increasingly difficult, and it almost becomes laughable that every day my phone will go and somebody will say, hi, I'm relocating from Manhattan or San Francisco or LA or Chicago. And I'm like, great, you're the third guy today. And it just, with no sign of that slowing down, and we don't have enough product to absorb, I guess the creativity is going to come into play as we go through our season.
Absolutely.
And they think they want to be sensible in the way they move, and they call first and say, we want to rent. We want to rent this season. And it's just not available.
The rental market.
There are no rentals.
Any level.
We've had offers on rentals, and I think we've had this on one of our other videos when we were shooting with the top agents in Miami, and we were dealing with Bill Hernandez, and we were also dealing with Brian Serenity and Nick Duchon. And the conversation that we had is that we've got rentals on properties that would normally get $20,000 a month, and they're getting $50,000
easily. Mm-hmm.
We're getting people who are saying, I know that you've got an offer, but I'm going to give you 20 grand or more, and they just, it's just no end to it. So I guess, look, I think that the takeaway is, if you're going to come down to South Florida, if you're going to be in focused on Palm Beach, if you decide this is where you want to plant your flag, these are your guys. If you want to be in Miami, I'm your guy. And this dialogue we'll continue to have. I know that when I have a question, I'm going to be calling you guys. Likewise, if you have questions ever in my neck of the woods, we'll talk.
We're definitely calling you from Miami. You're fabulous.
Love it.
We didn't really have a chance to get to know each other before this, so we're impressed.
This is perfect. Well, thank you again, Ashley. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chris, thank you.
Our pleasure.
And as always, click below, see my email, my telephone number, follow us, and stay tuned for more videos to come.